Hendrik would be 10 years old in 10 months. All his life he had heard about the dikes. He knew that a big part of Holland, his homeland, lay below the level of the sea, and the only things that protected it from being flooded were the dunes and dikes. The dikes, which were made by humans, were the most important. From very long ago, Hollanders had put up great mounds of earth and sod to save their land from the tides. It was a cruel war between the rising of the sea and the strength of the dikes, and for many years the sea threatened to win. But the Hollanders loved their country and would not allow the sea to drive them out from there. They fought back the waters that roared in from the North Sea. They protected the soil with longer and larger dikes, using barriers of clay and stone as well as bricks. Hendrik's grandfather had been a dike builder. His father looked after dike repairs. His uncle was in charge of a polder, an area of reclaimed land, surrounded by dikes. Hendrik admired the way the dike was constructed. Its tall, grassy flanks and the great stone blocks on the seaside put there to break the violence of the onrushing waves. He would imagine himself standing on the wall as if it were a rampart and would give a victory call to the sea. He would make expeditions into the countryside, exploring the turns and twists of the walls, examining the ways in which they were built, trying to guess their age. One day, he roamed further than he had ever gone, much further than he had intended. The sky was darkening when he turned towards home. There was no time to watch anything except the shady, unfamiliar road. It was a still, chill, stormy evening. The birds had gone to their nests. There was no sound in the air except Hendrik listened intently. He did not want to believe what he heard, but he knew only too well what it was. It was the sound of water. Nothing much, only a trickle, but Hendrik knew what it would mean. He knew that the trickle would soon become a gurgle. Then there would be a gush, followed by a rush, and then a roar, and the North Sea would sweep in. For a moment, he stood bewildered. It was growing dark, hard to see, harder to locate a small leak in the dike. Finally, he found it, a few feet from the ground. He could reach it. It was, as he suspected, a small leak, small enough to be stopped with one finger. At first, he was not worried. He even felt a little heroic, elated to see that the finger of one small boy could hold the mighty waters in check. Besides, he thought, it would not be long. Someone was sure to pass by, see what was happening, and get people to repair the damage. But the stillness continued. Stillness and loneliness. As the night came on, Hendrik grew colder. His hand pained him. There were cramps in his arm. Soon his entire side felt numb. He could not tell how long he had hunched there. Hours seemed to pass. He called and cried, but there was no answer. No help came. The pain frightened him, but he could not take his finger from the dike. The air was freezing. He was afraid he would drop from fatigue. He stamped his feet to stamp out the cold. He rubbed his still arm with the fingers of his other hand to keep the blood flowing. He was dizzy. Pain stabbed every part of his body. But he would not remove his finger from the dike. It was almost dawn when he saw the man with the lantern in his hand. Hendrik almost fainted. It was a laborer returning after working all night. Hendrik's parents had been searching for him all night, but it was this laborer who found the boy. He immediately called for help. The leak was plugged soon. The dike was strengthened in weeks. A great part of Holland was saved. Years passed, and many things were forgotten. But the country is still grateful to the boy who kept his finger in the dike.